If you want insane deals on legit PC keys from great developers, use my Fanatical link down below and start saving yourself some money. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Big Fry, and I want to talk to you guys about Insurgency Sandstorm. We haven't had an update to the game since December 21st. I was actually kind of wondering, like, what the hell is going to be happening? Are we going to see some sort of update within the next, like, week or so? If we didn't get anything in January, I think I'd be pretty disappointed. I know we were busy with the holidays and all that, but, like, I feel like this game still has a lot of things that needs to be addressed, and I already have a bunch of console people asking when the game is dropping over there. I don't think we're quite there on PC yet, so I was hoping that we were going to see something. Luckily, NWI has come through. They dropped a community update today. This isn't a new game update, but it does discuss what we can expect in the February update. So we're not getting an update in January, but at least we kind of know what the hell is going to be going on here. So they've announced 5 new weapons, including the MP5A5, the MP5A2. Now they don't go in, that's the only two that they've announced out of the 5, but it's going to be available for the Breacher classes on Security and Insurgent. We're going to see a new community testing environment right in the Steam library. This is what they say, it's for easy and more open testing of upcoming updates. So basically like a PTE, a public test environment. Competitive improvements, including, now get this, including tiebreaker rounds, leave penalties, and more. The tiebreaker rounds is one thing that I have been just bitching about and asking for since like before launch. So now that we're here, tiebreaker rounds are going to be a thing in competitive, and I am super fucking excited for that. It makes no sense that we could draw competitive games. In casual, all right. Fair enough. I still don't like the idea of drawing a game, but in competitive, it's an absolute necessity. So we're going to be having that. Vote kick is coming in community servers, and they say additional anti-harassment / griefing measures. And they actually double down in this post and explain why they don't want to do the vote kick option in official servers, because they don't want it to be abused. I feel, from all the time that I've played Insurgency and even other shooters on the market, I feel like the vote kick option is a lot easier to have than dealing with fucking griefers and trollers and team killers. The idea that the vote kick option can be abused more than somebody just coming in and team killing, I've never experienced that. Maybe once or twice I've seen a team come in and vote somebody out, but that was, you know, 12 years ago on SOCOM. Other than that, I've never seen it be abused in the way that they're doubling down and saying it. But at the end of the day, it's their game, it's their decision. I can voice my opinion on that. I think official servers having vote kick would actually be better, but that's just me. Let me know what you guys think down below. I know this is like a hot topic in the community. I see a lot of people for it. I see some people that are against having vote kick. Let me know what you guys think. Clearer indications around restricted areas, game rules, and spawn waves. I'm curious to see what they're going to be doing with this. I felt that it was a lot harder to figure out what the restricted areas were in Insurgency Source. I think it's pretty clear cut in Insurgency Sandstorm. Once you see it once, you know that you're going to basically not be able to shoot here. There are some areas in a map like Crossing where you're trying to rotate from B to C on security side, and you realize that running on the right side of the road, which is pretty much your only route to take, actually puts you in a like restricted area, so you can't actually shoot for like 2 or 3 seconds. I feel like stuff like that just needs to be ironed out a little bit better design on that. New camouflages are coming, new gloves, new eyewear, and then they go on to say some other surprises you might not expect. And on top of all of this, they say performance and optimization will continue to be the top priority for them. Player systems and setups vary greatly. It's important that we gather as much info as possible. We encourage everyone who is having issues to submit information to our team via the performance discussion and support. And that's why when we talk about the performance issues of Sandstorm, I like if you guys do end up commenting down below, let us know what your specs are. Don't just tell us it's a GTX 1070. Let us know that you're plugging it into an i5, an i3, an i7, whatever the case is. It just makes it easier, because I do know that the devs watch these videos, and even though we're not submitting it through the performance discussion on the forums, I still think that they look and they take a look and they take all of that information into account. Now, they also touch on the topic of in-game reporting. I know that's a huge want in the community. And what they say, and they basically explain why they haven't done it yet. It's still an option. It's still on the table. But what they say is when you have so many in-game reports coming, for a team their size to take somebody away to read all the reports, go through, check VODs, check all of that, check the replays. It's a lot of work, and I agree with them on that. It is a lot of fucking work. I don't know what the balance is here, though, because if we don't have vote to kick in official servers, and we don't have in-game reporting, there's nothing to protect. Yeah, you have the team killing thing, it inflicts damage back. You have nothing to protect players from griefers. There's people who will run around and just stand in front of you while you shoot, so you get the team damage delivered back to you. It's definitely frustrating. On top of, like, you're playing, and then you get the performance issues, and then you have to deal with that shit. It's super frustrating. So without the in-game reporting system, without the vote to kick in official servers, I don't know what they can do to make it a better experience. I mean, honestly, I don't think I run into griefers that often. I have seen videos of people just trolling and being fucking losers. I don't run into it that often, so it's not a big issue for me, but obviously I'm just one person, and if the community's talking about it, it's gotta be a bigger issue than even I see, so we gotta figure out something. And that's pretty much it. That's what to expect in the February update. For everyone who is asking about when this game is going to be launching on consoles, guys, I have no idea. They haven't put a release date yet. They're trying to get the PC build up to date, bring the content for the PC players. If I were to put a date on it or put a month on it, I would say sometime around September. It was supposed to be launching in the first half of 2019. That was before they hit us with like a 3-month delay to get the game proper for launch. I'm going to say September. And that's just a fucking guess to me. I have no idea. I think if they were to look at it, that's 9 months of development and polish for the console release. I think looking at a September release, you're going to be most likely before a Call of Duty. You're going to be most likely around the time of whatever fucking Battlefront is coming out. I don't think they're going to have a lot of competition in the multiplayer realm in September. Now, again, something might be announced at E3 that we have no idea about. But I feel like that's a good fucking slot for a game coming out that's not full price, that, you know, is a competitive tactical shooter. I think that's a decent month. I think that's a decent guess to me. But again, we don't even know if the game's going to be ready. So that's just me speculating. Leave a comment down below if you guys think it's going to be a different month. If you think it's not even going to launch this year at all, let me know. I want to hear your thoughts in the comments. I appreciate you guys watching. If you guys haven't hit the subscribe button already, we're shooting for 100,000 subscribers. We are now 13,000 away from hitting that goal, guys. I want to eventually be one of the largest tactical shooter channels on this platform. I want to cover all of these games. You guys know what it is. If you enjoy the content, make sure you hit the like button. Leave a comment down below. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Big Fry, and I'll see you on the next one.